Hi, it's Tuesday. We're going to do a meet don't class. And if you remember last time, we were talking about really putting in effort and strategizing on how to get rid of that main root mita that you have, that I have, that we all have, that we each have, that's different, that's our tikkun in life. And, you know, we talked about strategies and how to do that. But now Netivot Shalom is saying that's one thing, and you totally have to work on it. And you even have to devote your life to it, you know, to getting rid of that major, like, force or root of evil within you, because it's like, it's really making you into a miserable person. Your whole life is miserable, and you can't really get close to Hashem if you don't really work on it. I'm going on like on 6 weeks with this cold and this cough. It's ridiculous. But on the other hand, to start working on the positive is immeasurable. Like, you haven't yet changed your essence into a person with good midot if you just get rid of the bad part of you. Now, nobody's saying that that's not amazing. It's amazing. But just by the fact that, let's say, you worked on yourself and you're no longer lazy or kind of given to despair or sadness, doesn't yet mean that you acquired the positive opposite mita of zrizut, alacrity, energy, jumping up and doing things as soon as they come your way, real simcha, real like joy and happiness and enjoying life, right? And enjoying the little moments in life and taking real pleasure in every moment. Okay, we haven't become that yet. That's like someday, right? So we worked so far, or we were talking so far about really trying to uproot the bad. But to really work on the good is a whole other level, and it can change you into a really different person. That's what changes you into a good person and into a different person. Like, if you work on this for like 20 years, like slowly but surely, you see, and I'm sure some of us who are my age, you know, we can look back and we can see that we're really different people from the way we were 20 years ago, 30 years ago. And it's hard because, like, sometimes, let's say people that are like our spouses or our family, people that have known us for the last 30 years, you know, they're used to something and it's hard for them to see that you actually changed. So I think we should each take some moments and say to ourselves, how have we changed in the last 30 years? There's a good chance we really have. And if nobody else sees it, or if people are expecting certain things of us or still say that we're certain ways, and we know that we're not, that is something that we should take pleasure in, we should take pride in, even if nobody else gives us credit for it. Okay, because it makes a difference to really realize, you know what? I'm not mean anymore. Or I'm not judgmental anymore, you know? It's a big, big deal. Okay. But if we want to start working on the positive, hold on, I'm going to show you what he says because I feel like he says it really, really well. Okay. So there's three areas that we need to work on. And that is something that comes up in my trips all the time. And those of you who are on my trips know that this is like my pretty much basic theme, that we have three areas of positive work that we need to do. And that comes from Maharal, where he says that if you have to be shalem im atzmo, you have to be wholehearted with yourself, or whole with yourself, complete, perfect. Shalem im chaverav, you have to be whole or perfect with your friends or with others. V'shalem im boro, and perfect or complete with Hashem. Those are the three areas in our lives that we're going to work on, okay? And basically, if you really take the time and you start working mida by mida on, like, how do I work on myself, my inner harmony, my inner completeness, my inner wholeness? How do I work on my relationships with friends? And thirdly, how do I work on my relationship with Hashem? Those are the areas. You are on the road to perfection, ladies. Okay, so let's start, says Netivot Shalom. Ki amarti olam chesed yibaneh. We're in essay number 6 in the Midot section, if those of you who want to follow along or read along afterwards. Midat hachesed, okay? just in case you wanted to know, which is the midah that we should start working on if we're working on the positive? It's midat ha-chesed. Midat ha-chesed hi rosh lechol ha-midot ha-tovot. It's the head. It's the start. It's the top priority in terms of good midot to work on. Why? How do you know that? It's the most similar to Hashem. Hashem is all chesed. Hashem is all good. He created this world out of chesed. He says something interesting in Tzivot Shalom. Kol inyanei chesed ve'ahava shayachim lebinyan ha'olam. The entire building of this world, the creation of this world, is all based on chesed and love. So what does that mean, all the building of this world? He even says, like, even reproduction, procreation. What is reproduction? Procreation. Even to bring to the continuity of the species, bringing children into this world, is based on love, right? That's how you create. So you see that it's exactly what Hashem is showing us, is that just like He is giving to us and building the world through chesed, we can do that as well. Interesting. So everything, like, it's like, and it's also the height of happiness and joy that we can achieve in this life is through loving. We know that that's when you are happiest, is when you are in the company of people that you love, when you are loving, when you are giving. It's all about chesed and love. Okay, so that is the key. All right, so we're going to start working on loving and kindness. All right, now, we basically have to realize that that's the most important thing. And we become, if we can become a person of chesed, we can be the source of blessing. Like Abraham, it says, "Veheye bracha," you become blessing. Anybody who has anything to do with you will be blessed. Anything that has business, dealings with you will be blessed. Anybody who has any interaction with you will feel blessed, will feel happier, because you become a source of blessing by virtue of the fact that you are working on your chesed. What does that mean? There's being chesed, giving chesed physically, obviously, with your money, tzedakah. That's one form of chesed. Another form of chesed is just empathy and feeling for your friends and giving them a listening ear, giving them your attention, giving them compliments, smiling at them. There's emotional giving, there's physical giving, there's helping. There's spiritual giving, when you teach somebody something or you influence them for the positive in terms of spirituality. All of that is chesed. Okay, but here's the key. And that's what I'm going to be done with right now, because I don't want to take too long. First of all, one more key is that you bring down chesed from Hashem to you and your life when you give chesed to others. Okay, listen to this. כאשר יהודי מתנהג במידת החסד, as soon as you start behaving with חסד, זוכה שהנהגת הבורא יתברך איתו, מלמעלה היא גם כן במידת החסד. Hashem starts behaving with you through חסד. Wow. So if you're just like a little bit annoyed at how things are going in your life, and you feel like Hashem is treating you maybe a little bit with judgment and justice as opposed to חסד, you start working on your chesed to others, and you will see that there will be an effect, like the same measure for measure. You will receive blessing from above, chesed from above. Wow, that's so cool, okay? And last but not least, I wanted to clarify that we have to realize that a person who is an ish chesed is very different from a person who does chesed. Oseh ma'aseh chesed is a person who just does a lot of chesed. Like, you know those people who do chesed, right? There are those, you know, they get involved with projects. Now, all that is great, and that's fine. And it could very well be that some of those people who do chesed are also an ish chesed, a person of chesed. But the way to see it is, do you run after chesed? Do you run? Don't wait for people to ask you, and don't wait to see a poor person on the street, or don't wait for somebody to, like, you know, tell you all their problems and what they need. You start looking around for chesed. And it shouldn't necessarily come from a feeling of mercy or for a feeling of pity or a feeling of even compassion on somebody else. You know, don't, it's like it tugs at your heartstrings. Oh, Nebuch, I feel so bad for them. I need to give them. No, it should come from a true inner desire to give, to love. Like you're just looking around. What can I do? Do you remember Abraham, how he left Hashem and he was looking for guests? Like, okay, hang on. I see some guests. I need to get them. Not like me, who I'm just thinking to myself, oh no, a couple of students asked me if they could come this Shabbat. Do I really want them? Da, da, da. Oh yeah, I guess I have to have them. No, that's not an Ish Chesed. Ish Chesed looks for guests, looks for ways to do Chesed. Okay, so let's try and work on that. And one more last thing, and with this I will end. Every day, Yom Shelo Asa Bo Chesed, a day that a Jewish person has not done chesed, lo nichshav leyom b'yamav, b'chayav. It is not considered a day in your life, okay? So for the next week, we're going to try and do at least one chesed that is just for the purpose of getting out of ourselves, giving, seeing what I can give, seeing how I can just be loving and outward-centered and outgoing and just friendly and giving. Okay, we're going to try and work on that this week. Once a day, every day a chesed. Let's work on that.